ago when I was building the first marble machine. I was doing everything by hand and I had no drawings and everything was kind of improvised. And these hand-cut gears actually did work. But when you looked at the machine as a whole and added up the sum of all the errors combined, it was just not good enough. It became very clear to me that to be able to build a functional marble machine that we can take on a tour with Wintergatan, I needed to be able to cut plywood with much higher precision. So welcome to this series where we are going to build a functional marble machine, the Marble Machine X. And this first episode will be all about the machine that will build the machine, a CNC machine. This is the island Brenne where I live, and on the shipyard of Brenne I have this small tiny white container. And in this small tiny white container we were going to try to assemble the CNC machine. The CNC machine came in 2 million boxes and it was actually like building a big Lego kit. I think the instructions were 300 pages long and it was actually quite fun. And it became so much more fun because Karin and Olof Enroth from the Marble Machine X development team came up to help. Neither one of us had ever built or even seen a CNC machine in our lives before. So we were really on unknown territory. We just chewed off one page of Lego instructions by the time, and it slowly started to come together.
1, 2, 3, then twist and go back.
Here we're assembling the stepper motors. The stepper motors take signals from the computer and turn them into precise movement. And here we're assembling the C axis. This is the axis that can go up and down on the gantry. The gantry is the horizontal bar that you can see me working on here. So after 2 days of assembly, we were ready to do our first tests. So we just heard the machine, the CNC machine, work for the first time. We heard the sound and we saw the gantry moving around, and it was like seeing Frankenstein's little finger like start to move. It feels like such a big step because like when I decided to build a new machine and not be happy with the first one, the Marble Machine X, I knew it was a big decision, and this is the kind of processes that I knew was necessary to get the precision we need. So, and now there's no turning back, you know, when we have this whole thing to play with. I'm happy that the machine is already working after 2 days, but I'm also confused to ask why it is working. CNC machine, and today I'm gonna make some fine adjustments. You and I are gonna have a lot of fun together. Yes. Virus detection. What's a virus? These things, that's the flu.
Martin, this, that's so old.
Yeah. Here you can see me really struggle with a tiny space in this container. Even if the fisheye makes it look big, trust me, it's barely doable to have this big machine in this space. This CNC is built by the company CNC Routerparts. I reached out to CNC Routerparts and told them that I was building another marble machine and that I was thinking of using a CNC machine for that. And they were big fans of the first marble machine and they decided to help me by sending me this machine free of charge. I wanted to say a big thanks to Nathan and CNC Routerparts for believing in the project. This has been a huge push forward in the process of me trying to actually build a functional marble machine X. After getting to know Nathan, we actually started to collaborate on the design of the Marble Machine X itself. He has become part of the Marble Machine X development team, and the team is now me plus 6 engineers. So I have 6 engineers helping me getting this machine working, and it makes all the difference in the world from building the first machine by myself. Together, we will get this done. Here I'm leveling the working surface to the gantry by making a surface cut of the whole piece, and then I'm putting another 19mm MDF on top, and the working table is done and straight. Now I'm going to explain to you exactly how a CNC machine works. It's basically 4 steps. First, you have to design the thing you want to make. And then you have to design it in the computer. In this computer, you can also simulate how the tool will act. And then we go to this computer and then we start the machine. I made a mistake in the toolpath. These holes should not go all the way through. I'm gonna go and correct my mistake and make another one. In all my excitement, I loaded the old faulty file again. Human error for the second time. Third time's the charm, right? So let me repeat why we are doing all this. I have a vision of an arena with 10,000 people and a marble machine on the stage. The concert starts and the marble machine is backlighted, and I walk up to the marble machine and I start turning the wheels, and a massive beat erupts from the speakers of the stadium and the crowd starts dancing. That's the goal with all this. And we want to cover the whole process of working towards that goal here on the Wintergatan Wednesdays. Thanks for watching.